all coupe, hopping out like Jack in the Box, nigga. I'm gonna shoot if this 30's all that I got, nigga.
What time is
it? Time's up.
All right, what's good with y'all? It's your boy DJ T. No G-Ray. Fuck that nigga.
What's your name?
T.O. Just my initials, y'all. I'm going by T.O. now. Everyone got the DJ T, the G-Ray. So I'm the T.O.
Okay.
So you know.
Looking for trouble back in here again. But today, Schoolboy Q drops an album. We are very, very happy.
I'm kind of in the middle, you know, because I love TDE. But in terms of like who I'm listening to, he's, well, not TDE, Black Hippie, he's at the bottom.
He's my favorite out of Black Hippie, towards the top of my TDE list as well.
Who else? Oh, Isaiah.
Isaiah. But he dropped the album Crash Talk. Do you have any anticipation for it, first of all?
I love when artists say like this is their best project, because it makes me like, oh, you actually care about this. Because a lot of artists, they just put out albums and just like, go listen to this. But when someone says they put a lot into this, because he said he scrapped like a bunch of albums.
He said he scrapped like three albums.
Yeah. He said they were trash. So I was like, if you put this one out, like, you better.
Schoolboy definition of trash is like, he be clowning shit, saying like, clowning saying shit trash. I really, really doubt it was actually trash. But I mean, nonetheless, we're going to go and get right into it. This is Gang Gang, Schoolboy. Let's get it.
Take one.
Whole lot of fucking gang shit. Okay, Q.
I'm not a West Side nigga, but like, I love doing that. You said it's only 40 minutes. I realize like a lot of these niggas been putting out shorter albums.
Yeah.
The past couple years.
That's the trend now.
Game was only like 40 minutes.
What'd you think of the first track?
It was cool. I like the first one because I know there's, once you actually listen to it in your headphones or with bass, that shit goes. And then it's supposed to transition right into the next song. So I fucked with it.
Okay.
Like the first time I listened, I was just listening for the beat, but this one I was kind of listening to the lyrics.
Off first listen, it's like, whatever. I could tell it was supposed to transition into it because it kind of just stopped abruptly. A lot of my favorite rappers are starting to do that thing when they just repeat the same fucking lyrics like five times in a fucking row. And I hate when anyone does that, not just my favorite rapper. So, it's going to have to probably grow on me, but we'll see. We're going to go straight into Tails, though. I like this one a lot more already.
When I heard this one, I was like, oh, shit.
Nigga.
I just find it fascinating how like they're just niggas out there that just like, oh, I can just put words together. It's like, that shit is beautiful.
This really, it's crazy.
They made this nigga rap, and I'm like, he's such a good rapper.
He is.
They had to make this nigga rap, and I'm like, nigga, you see all this talent.
This shit is depressing. Nigga, damn, Q. You trying to make niggas cry? What the fuck is he doing? Wow, okay, I'm hurt. This is emotionally. The fuck we supposed to be doing with that, man? I like that shit. That was that blank face vibe to me. Beat just going, he just kind of just saying
just
shit.
Talking.
The way he story tells is fucking crazy because he just be putting like, shit together, but like it makes sense. All right, we're going to go into the next one. We already heard this one. This is Chapsticks. We're going to hear it again right now, but if you want to hear our actual reaction to Chapsticks, you can watch our previous video. I'm going to shoot if this 30's all that I got, nigga. Time's up. Got my coins up, my balls up. I remind you that what you think you got is not true. Where you find her, she a kickstand, a big stand. I'm here behind her. When I slid it in, I went away. I mean, that's bitch shit. Saying it because you know it's summer. Yeah, that's bitch shit. You a bitch boy, you're my mama. Okay, let's get it. Hey! All right, so that was Num Num Juice. We already know our thoughts on Num Num Juice are just always. This is a new shit. This is a drunk.
Featuring
6 Lakh. I ain't really drunk. I ain't really drunk. I ain't really drunk. I ain't really drunk. I like the instrumental so far, but he's not really doing shit with it.
Yeah, this is weird. Not weird, but it's like.
I feel like I need to listen to this at like nighttime.
Or maybe when you're drunk.
Or maybe when I'm drunk. This is a black track that just Schoolboy got. He's used this flow multiple times. This Num Num Juice.
Yeah. This is something else too.
What do you think of that one?
That was cool. I gotta listen to it again.
I gotta listen to that one like properly with like some headphones in, because I feel like I'm not getting it the right way right now. But overall, I feel like black kind of stole the show.
Cause even though he only had like a bridge.
He really had a bridge, and like I feel like that was more of his song than Schoolboy's song. All right, so this is Lies featuring Ty Dolla $ign and YG.
These are all relatively short songs.
They're all like about 3 minutes, yeah. Oh, shit. Okay, I see it already. Yes.
Yeah.
Who produced this?
He got some singles now.
Who produces one? I feel like this is Hitmakers, I feel like.
Soundwave? Baby King.
Look at Soundwave. This is a hit.
YG400.
Hey. It sounds like Dangerous song. Meek Mill's out. Kinda low key, one of those things. Mm-hmm. Ty Dolla $ign's on that too, right?
No, that's
PNB, right?
That's PNB.
That's it.
And Jeremiah.
That nigga sound like.
I can see niggas using pulling this out in court whenever a bitch trying to sue him. You ain't got no leverage. Bitch trying to sue me. What? Stop telling lies. What do you think of that one?
That's a bop. I was kind of underwhelmed with Q on this, to be honest.
So far, it's not really seeming like a Q album. It's seeming like this is definitely like Q's damn already, where it's like he's just making going for that commercial sound.
Yeah. All them niggas did that, to be honest, because J-Rock just put out his
Redemption was kind of commercial. Shape.
Absol, don't do it.
Absol, long term three, nigga. He been saying LT3 gonna be the one when he makes it. He makes LT3 when he makes it. He about to make it with that shit. Watch, nigga's about to be poppy as fuck. If Absol do that shit, then I know it's different. I know TDE really different though. That's gonna be crazy. But still, this is a 5200.
I like this one.
I'm fucking with this too.
He ain't fucking with the hoes on this album.
Oh, facts.
Fuck these hoes.
One of these Instagram thoughts really fucked up Q.
That baby mama drama.
And that baby mama drama too. So what do you think of that one?
I like that a lot.
Like that a lot?
Yeah.
I like that one a lot too. One thing I will say, I'm noticing how like all like... Back in 2011, 2012, like, you would call everyone a black hippie, like, the lyrical ones.
Yeah.
And now, like, they all kind of switching up and doing, like, the mainstream flow. All of them is. So, I feel like that song was, the perfect balance of, like, being able to still do that mainstream flow, but also still trying to retain some of that lyricism as well. So, with that being said, I really fuck with that one. This next one is called Black Folk.
Black Folk.
Okay, I like this already. That's like the third time he's used that Num Num Juice flow. That's the third time on this album already. I'm getting worried, Q. Still liking this track, though. I fuck with that.
Shit. That's how niggas be.
That is how niggas
be. Niggas really be too.
That was Black Folk.
I fuck with that.
Like that one? I like that one too. I feel like I need to listen to that one more. He feel like he was actually saying some shit on there. I was only catching the tail end of it.
Yeah, I kind of zoned out until like
the last little verse. Little yeah. Same. But I enjoyed it a lot. This next one is Floating featuring 21 Savage. Got it on my waist.
Let that shit rock. I'm floating. Let that shit rock.
Okay. Yes. Had to bounce right quick. You can't do nothing for me unless you leave the hickeys where my dick be. 21. Ain't savage free calls get punched just for trying to kiss. 21. You punch just for trying to kiss. Yo, 21 has been on his features tear. Cause he fucked up Meek shit. He been fucking up. He fucked up G Herbo shit. He fucked up this shit. What do you think of that one? That's a good one too. I'm fucking with that one too. I was expecting this album to be a little bit more commercial, but I wasn't expecting to like the commercial shit, to be honest with you. A compliment to Q. All right, now this is my most anticipated track. This right here is my most anticipated track. This is Dangerous.
As long as we get some humming, I'm good.
Some corny. Oh yes, distorted guitars. Oh, I'm about to cry. They're pitching the guitar. Do you hear that? Oh wow.
This should just
exactly. This got me tripping. And I'm sober as fuck. Father.
This, see, you keep this shit away from depressed people. I don't need to hear this when I'm sad.
Oh, I'ma love this.
I'ma be Cuddy?
Without no Crash Talk Take 3. That was it? I'm mad you wasted. I'm not gonna say he wasted it.
Cause it was, I liked good him for then, what it was.
But like,
you wanted more.
I feel like Cuddy was about to drop a whole fucking verse. He about to murder that shit. They busted that shit. He did the same shit Q did. I'm like, Crash Talk Take 3. Bitch, what the fuck? No, nigga. Okay. It's okay. I'm gonna appreciate that track for what it is. I like it still.
Me too.
Cuddy should have rapped, but it's alright though. This is a deal with him.
Die with him.
So this is Die With Him.
This nigga is.
I can't. I'm blind.
What is up with this violence against women?
Heard your record. I'm your father.
Oh, okay, never mind. See, I wasn't listening. Oh, he hit the bitch. I thought he meant like, what is up with this violence against women?
Yo, you fucked up, man.
Gotta lock in.
Please, dude. About to accuse nigga of some shit. Ain't even hear the lyrics. Schoolboy Q, woman beater.
See, the Q in Schoolboy Q stands for qualified woman beater.
Where'd the WB come from?
It's all one word.
I'm gonna get some action shit.
I still can't. I did this shit on my story yesterday. They say it's supposed to be like stiff. But it, you depends. Know, I'm a no rhythm ass nigga.
It depends on how
I
you
feel like you're gonna edit the fuck out of this. Nah, and it's gonna be looking
it's
like
gonna be alright. Stupid.
I'm gonna stop giving you material.
you already given me enough, dog, for this song alone.
Pause.
Jesus, we are terrible people. That was Die With Him. I thought it was alright.
It just came and went, to be honest.
I understand. For you, I feel like that's gonna slap. I feel like I'm gonna be having that in the headphones, and when I'm in the gym, I'm gonna be blasting that shit. I feel like that's gonna be one of them. This is a Crash. He dropped this as a single Monday or Tuesday.
This whole week went by, and I missed that shit.
It did.
I heard more about Rico Nasty than this nigga. That shit sound like in middle school when you used to fart on the desk hard as fuck, and it would vibrate.
Damn. Talk about it, Q.
Man, talk, nigga.
Talk to them young black queens out there. Stop putting them down. You thought he was gonna say it. Little bitch, what you think?
I like that. I really like that. I wish I'd heard it earlier.
It's a really good song.
Yeah, it sounds really good.
He's actually talking about some shit. It's very unique. Well, not unique, but like it's like the most standard Schoolboy Q song I've heard on this album, I think. When it's like, okay, this is exactly what I wanted. We're gonna move on to the next one, though.
You can get the picture.
This is a Water featuring Lil Baby. 808s.
This sounds like an old man outside the corner. Hey, bro, I got that water, man. Got that water, young brother. Stay warm.
I wasn't expecting this many ad-libs from Schoolboy Q. This is very interesting.
Is this Lil Baby or Schoolboy?
I don't know. There, baby. Baby killed that shit.
I know.
I'm mad at Q now. Like, what the fuck was that? I feel like Q was trying to do what Baby do. And Baby just said,
Slick, that's every feature. The nigga got Q. Q got caught on every song that had a feature.
Black called him. Cuddy.
Black had a bridge, my nigga.
Black had a bridge, he called his ass. Who else?
Cudi was on. I don't know about Chopsticks, because, well, Chopsticks grew on me a little bit, but.
Like, Chopsticks is a Travis Scott song.
It's Travis's song. 21 was on, yeah.
21 was going crazy.
Yeah.
YG and, well, Ty really went crazy on that shit.
Yeah.
Still, is this the last track? This is the last track of the album. This is Attention. And it's 3 minutes. Look at it.
You better be talking that shit, nigga.
Blank face. Blank face. Raises
from Jay. I'm fucking with this beat. I'm happy you know my name. Favorite rapper Nas being told me that I'm the best. Had a couple sessions with you. Got a pile of rest to sprinkle some orange in my. I love TDE. God damn. They all like. I'm gonna wait till song.
Nigga. This shit is grimy as fuck and I love it. That ain't it, is it? Damn, he only gave us a verse.
I know.
I'm mad. I wanted another one. That's one thing I hate about the new industry shit, where like they only give you like one or two verses. And like, they'd never give you a third. Like, dog, you could murder this shit if you really wanted to. But, like, niggas ain't listening, I guess. Shit. But that was great, yeah, though. This is a great way to end the album.
That's what I was gonna say. I love the, like, TDE niggas. It's like, well, the last three people that dropped projects. I know Kendrick dropped Duckworth, and it was just like, I'm gonna tell a story. Mm-hmm. J-Rock on Redemption was telling a story. This shit was like, ah! I love when them niggas do this.
These niggas really have a formula now.
I know.
I'm worried about everyone else now.
As in what?
TDE? Like, okay, so, like, for example, if Abso does the same shit, or, like, he comes through and, like, he's trying to not necessarily, like, be commercial, but, like, he's not as... We would both agree he's, like, the lyrical one. He's, yeah, like, the one that's, like, doing, like, the most, like, left-field shit out of Black Hippie. So if he comes through and he's on, like, some Cardo Got Wings beat, I don't really see this out of him, you know?
We were worried about this when we looked at the track list, though.
I was worried when I saw the track list, but, like, looking at it now, I was like, okay, it was good. I enjoyed it. Probably not ranking it that high on my Schoolboy Q albums off first listen. But that, once again, it's only a first listen. I didn't rank Blank Face that high off the first listen. I hated Blank Face when I first heard it because I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah, it took me like 2 years. It took me a year and some months to listen to it again after that summer it came out. I was like, niggas fuck with this?
It took me like 3 weeks because I was like, okay, I have to like this. Like, no, I'm tripping, right? And then like on like that fifth listen, it's like, oh, shit clicked. Because I already had like my favorites. Like, I think the Anderson .Paak, like the torture just threw me the fuck off.
I love that.
I love it now. I love it now. But like at first, I'm like, what the fuck is this? Why is this nigga just shut the fuck up? Off rip, I'll give it like a 7 out of 10.
Me too.
About that.
About a 7, yeah. All
right.
I feel like if Schoolboy really wanted to apply himself, he could be like, not up there with Kendrick, but like at that point when like he dropped Oxymoron and Man of the Year, and it was like, oh, he's the clear like, if Kendrick wasn't here, this nigga would be the face. Mm-hmm. But he kind of like drifted away from that. I think he'd get back there if he really wanted to. He just gotta get back to his, not say roots, but like get back to your shit.
I didn't realize how much niggas really fuck with Q, because when he dropped that part like 2016, that summer, like, oh, this song in the summer, I'm like, oh,
you niggas mean, always been with him since Collard Greens, fucking Manor. Yeah, like, all like that.
I ain't know, and niggas was really fucking with him like that. I'm like, okay, man, like I'm not the only one, but I think that same audience is gonna really appreciate 5200, that Lil Baby track, that 21 track. They already appreciated Num Num Juice, so I can see this going off, but I think that's all we got for you. This has been Looking for Trouble, DJ T, T-O, Looking for Trouble, and you found a motherfucker. Peace.